This is one that I remember seeing in a game shop and looking at the box and totally wanting it, because I love me brawlers, you know, like everything from Renegade to Streets of Rage. I love them, and this was a brawler, according to the pictures on the back of the box. This was all a bit of a letdown. I mean, alright, it's a movie game, and the graphics are nice there, and it's kind of digitised and pixel popped, and someone's put some work in, but it just, that doesn't capture the essence of a brawler to me. That. So, I'm already on edge. Oh, little, please help, we're stranded, we were hitchhiking and baddies came. Okay, we get it. Oh, more, Gabe, I need to get that money. Actually, no, it's Celeste, I need to get the, no, let's just not go there. Adrian! Okay, now I did play this, I think, a while ago, and I remember not really being that impressed by it, but it's, I'll tell you what, as far as I can tell, it's a damn sight better than the last Action Hero game, which feels amateurish. Although this has got a similar feel to it, just slightly better. the characters, at least, have got proportion, which, you know, isn't dead easy to do. But it's a sign of an experienced artist, and I can appreciate that. But I'm, you know, I'm not turned off. It's a little bit slow, monotonous, but it's no Streets of Rage. But I don't think it's trying to be. I think there's other elements to this game that make it a more unique brawler in itself. I can double tap and run. Yeah, it is a double tap. I wasn't sure if it was just doing it. It's nowhere near as good as Streets of Rage. Let's just establish that now. It's not trying to be Streets of Rage, though. I mean, it's got very kind of stringy, slow gameplay. Streets of Rage, you can't compare this. So let's not. This is a bit slow and dull. This reminds me of Final Fight on the Amiga, which didn't have scrolling control on the levels, as in it wasn't set piece. You couldn't scroll to an area, have it release baddies at you, and then continue, which sounds like a bad thing, but it's actually a good thing. I lost a life then, and I'm back at the beginning. That's crap. I've said crap again. There seems to be something I'm saying now. It's not deliberate. This run animation is a little bit funny. Hey, no, not at the beginning. That's good. Okay. I just didn't like the fact that it went dark and lit up again. But again, it's not trying to be Streets of Rage. I can't get a double jump to blue and white now. Hey! That was easier than I thought it would be. That's good. The worst bit of Double Dragon for me, apart from that horrible bit of coin guzzling it does at the end, you know, with the walls coming out of you and the little devil guys poking you with the sticks, is, I'm not going there, I'm not even rising to, is the bit on level 3 where you've got to jump over the lake. And let's face it, it's like knee-deep water at best. It wouldn't hurt you. You lose whole lives to that bit just because you can't get the jump right. There's nothing to be proud of if your game makes jumping over a hole really, really stupidly difficult. And this game doesn't make it stupidly difficult. I don't really like jumping over sections, but this is Cliffhanger after all. It's got to have those big drops. And this is just its way of doing it. I'm just happy that it decided to do it within a brawler. That said, that sucks. Hang on, maybe I can do it walking. Yeah, there you go. So I'm not complaining, that was just me being stupid. I should have done it at a walking pace. Yeah, Final Fight on the Amiga has this thing where you can just literally walk forward through the whole level and then it releases all of the baddies at once. You know, it releases all the baddies when you've killed baddies, I guess. And it doesn't relate to where you are in the level. And that's actually not a good thing for a game like this. You want the linear... It's a linear process. You want the linearity of it to be structured. And Final Fight on the Amiga doesn't do that very well. But then the guy who programmed it has pretty much publicly said he didn't really have any love for it. And the same with the Spectrum version. The guy who programmed it said he was rushed on the Amiga thing. The guy who did the Spectrum version, I think it was in Retro Game a few months ago, said he didn't really have any love for it. And you can tell, because it doesn't feel like Final Fight, even though the graphics look great, big, massive things. They were just ripped from the arcade, and quite badly. They didn't really do a good job of picking the right animations, in my opinion. And that whole thing about pressing left and right and fire to do a flying kick just killed the game for me. You should have been able to do like the... Anyway, that's not Final Fight. We're not talking about Final Fight. I'm going the wrong way. We're talking about Cliffhanger. I'll be honest, it's not bad. Hang on. Yeah, I thought so. Here we go. Oh no, I'm not so sure I like this though, because that was like really fast bullets. Oh, look at this. I'm sitting duck. Oh, I didn't like that. Yeah, continue. Come on. I don't really dislike this. Oh, that sucks. That was not a bit of the game to go back to the beginning of, you know. This, I shouldn't be this far back. I don't like that, but that's the worst thing about this game right now. Alright, it's not trying to be Streets of Rage, but it would be a better game if it didn't put you back to do a bit you've just done. I'm basically starting again. The continue is making me start again, and I can appreciate that on later levels. The continue would start me again at the beginning of that level, and it would make more sense. But right now, I might as well start again, because that's what I'm doing, just with one less credit, which I could save for later. I guess that's, to be honest, I guess that's all about just getting better at the game. I imagine you get to a point where you know this level so well that you don't lose a life doing it, or a credit for that matter. And you know, that's practice. That's retro games for you. Man up, Mike. Can I go up? No. See, where's the consistency? If I can go up that last one, why can't I go up this one? That, the bit where you can go up, it should be more obvious. I mean, I know it only took me 30 seconds to figure it out. I went left, I went right, and then I realised I had to go up. But there was just no clue. And I'm not saying it should guide you every step of the way, but just a bit of a hint, maybe in the way the wall's designed, would have been nice. It's not an awful game, if I'm honest. I thought this was going to be terrible. I was getting myself all hyped to really get into it, dig into it, and hate it. I quite like it. But I love brawlers, and especially love brawlers that do something a bit differently to other brawlers. I have to admit, there are some brawlers that people go on about as amazing, and I find really repetitive and dull. But weirdly, this isn't one of them at the moment. I'm sure it would make me angry later on. I'm sure there's going to be things that make me angry about it. Like that thing about starting the level again just sucked. I quite like this. I know this is repetitive what I'm doing, but it feels effective, if that makes sense. It feels like I'm getting a response. That knife is a good weapon to have. As a knife really would be, let's face it, in a fight, you'd basically be able to murder someone in one death punch with a knife. It should be effective. That is effective, look at it. That's well more effective than when I had no knife. I've just wiped them out. I enjoyed it, it was fun. It might not be particularly rich, deep gameplay, but it's fun. I like the fact that when you get knocked over, you don't lose the knife as well. I'm enjoying slashing these bad boys up. I'm gonna catch you up, sunshine. I'm gonna catch you up. Warm me hands, is that a health thing? Or is it just, yeah, look, I got my health back. Right, let's just go up, because arsing about didn't work. I'm gonna die. All right, I see, he's on a timer. That means we can do it, it's been designed. Can we go diagonally? That's what I wanna do. Two shots, go. We can, but very, very slowly. Oh, come on. That wasn't right. Uh-oh. I see you. Okay. I get it. It's trajectories and diagonal lines. And it's you know what it is? Midnight Resistance level 2. Ooh, don't fall. Oh, don't make me start again. Good. At least I've got my lives. You know that Midnight Resistance bit where you've got them all and they only shoot either diagonally or straight? I'm going to go straight. No, that was a bad move. I'm going sideways. Oh, that was a bad move. Oh. Okay, the best thing to do. So you can lose too many lives, yeah. I think maybe, alright, bullets will kill you. But you'd also be able to see them coming a bit further away, so I don't know if that... It would balance out with some energy, is what I'm saying. It'd be a bit fairer. So you got to go along here. You know what, there is a hint. Look at the way the wall's got, like, white a bit. I'm on the edge here of the bit I can climb on. And I can tell that. Because the lighter bits stick out more. So I need to stop me whinging, really, don't I? He's going to shoot forward now. No, I don't like it. Okay, go. The timer's off. Oh, this is getting tricky. Oh, look at this. You know what? Crappy as this is, I quite like it. Oh, no! Oh, man. You've got to, like, find exact placing. I'm going to leave that there. That's annoying because I know I'm going to go back to the beginning of the level and I've got to do a fighting bit, which I enjoyed the first time. Not so much the second time, and the third time, I think I'll just be sick of it. You know what? That one little tweak could make this game so much better. It's not a terrible game. It's not great because it's got these flaws in it. But it was 20 quid in the shop when I saw it. I didn't have 20 quid, so I couldn't afford it. I was a teenager. Limited, you know, not ready to disposable income. And I couldn't buy it, but I wanted to. And I'm kind of glad I didn't, if I'm honest. Because there's just so many better games. Yeah, Cliffhanger, Sega Mega Drive, Genesis. Not as terrible as you think it is. Probably quite good if you get good at it. Thanks for watching.